to recognize the guys that came through, that paved the way. We need to let our kids know that successful people come out of our communities.
Baltimore, Maryland. Last year, Baltimore had the highest murder rate of any big city in America. Here, on the border of one of Baltimore's poorest neighborhoods, sits Edmondson Westside High School.
Well, a lot of our kids come from the impoverished neighborhoods.
Since you start in there, like, you don't want to end there. You know you got to get up out of there.
But this isn't your typical Baltimore story. This is a story of data analytics, a forgotten basketball legend, and the team of teenagers determined to keep his memory alive. More than four decades ago, these same hallways at Edmondson High School were walked by a 7'1" basketball phenom named Marvin Webster. What was your knowledge about Marvin going into this project?
I really didn't know much about, you know, Marvin Webster. Didn't know the Edmondson connection. I didn't have an in-depth knowledge of his accomplishments at all.
I had heard the name back and forth years ago, so I did hear about Marvin Webster. But I did not know how many rebounds he had. And to find out that how prolific of a scorer he was or his talent level, it was amazing.
Webster graduated in 1971 and received a scholarship to play basketball across town at Morgan State University. There, his shot-blocking ability earned him the nickname the Human Eraser.
We're in a game, I can't remember who we're playing. A little guard got the outlet pass, and he goes up to shoot, and Marvin goes up and just catches the ball right in midair. That right there was amazing.
Webster led Morgan State to the 1974 Division II National Championship.
He was the foundation. He was the person that we went through. Let's be real, we don't win the title without Marvin Webster. He was the man.
After averaging 20 points, 21 rebounds, and 8 blocks during Morgan State's championship season, Webster was the third pick of the 1975 NBA draft.
Blocked by Marvin Webster.
Webster, the left-handed running hook in the lane.
Webster with the rejection, the Human Eraser.
But a battle with hepatitis kept him from becoming a dominant NBA player. Even before he died in 2009 at age 56, Webster's legendary accomplishments in college had begun to fade from memory. That is, until last year.
What led you to pitch an analytics project to Baltimore City Public Schools?
What got me involved in sports analytics was identifying a societal problem in secondary education and identifying what a solution would be. And that solution would be to bring to young men and women data analytics in combination with sport to address the underrepresentation.
I know there are no boundaries for what my children can achieve. I loved the idea, and I knew that we had the perfect advisor for it. So I said, let's go for it.
My principal, Mr. Perry, wanted me to take on the endeavor, and then there was a task associated with it, a research project, and that was to see if we could help enhance the chance of Marvin Webster being inducted to the National Collegiate Basketball Hall of Fame. We were under deadline. The quickest thing for me to do was I recruited some of my top students from my football team.
We are in our data analytics club. We were presented with a research project to try to help and get a Marvin Webster, who was an Emerson graduate and a Morgan State graduate, elected to the National Collegiate Basketball Hall of Fame.
So Coach walks in and he mentions this name, Marvin Webster. What goes through your mind?
Who is this?
Who that?
No, I never heard the name before.
So I'm like, who?
Over the course of 6 weeks of research, the new Edmondson High School Sports Analytics Club discovered just who Marvin Webster was. The team of 10 students compared Webster's stats to other Collegiate Basketball Hall of Famers from the same era. Willis Reed, Walt Frazier, Earl Monroe, and Robert Parrish.
As I started going through the numbers and started looking at him, it was like, wow, I felt like offended that he was excluded.
That's tremendous, 23 rebounds a game. Wow.
In December 2017, the students produced a 25-page report supporting the case for Marvin Webster's induction
into the Collegiate Basketball Hall of Fame. You guys finished your project. It's submitted to the Hall of Fame. What did you think was going to happen?
Honestly, we didn't know the position we were in. We didn't know how the outcome would be. So we was hoping for the best, but preparing for the worst.
Did you think, based on what you did, that Marvin Webster would get into the College Basketball Hall of Fame?
No. I didn't think so.
3 months later, March 19th, 2018. Describe for me the moment you found out that all the hard work you put in paid off.
I felt really more excited for the kids because they were given a task, and a lot of times, a lot of things don't come to fruition. The kids were all committed to making this happen, and that we all came together, and we got him elected to the Hall of Fame.
Thanks to the students at Edmondson, Marvin Webster is now a member of the class of 2018 in the College Basketball Hall of Fame.
It made me feel good to know that I helped, like I was a part of it.
That moment, I felt the chill through my body, but I was excited at the same time because I found out that like all our hard work paid off.
I was amazed that young men who had no particular skill set in data analytics had actually gone in and done this type of weighty research. And that was the first time the hall had actually looked at a data-driven decision-making for an induction.
This is something that's going to impact, that's going to follow them for the rest of their lives. We made an impact on Marvin Webster's family and for Morgan State and the community, for Emerson and the community. And that it was just like, wow, we actually did this.